With the new update to iMovie, bringing Storyboards and Magic Movie, there are more ways than ever to create film on the iPad and iPhone. In this video, I'll show you 5 awesome tips to make your editing even better using these 2 new features. Here I've got a Magic Movie that I've made of a holiday to Cologne a couple of years ago. There are 3 different sorts of clips in this video. There are clips from the zoo, there are clips from some gardens that I visited, and then there are some nice time lapses looking out over the city. I want these time lapses to come first as an introduction to my movie. So I'm going to press select on that bottom toolbar, and then here I can quickly edit my clips. If I wanted to, I could select multiple clips at once and delete them really easily. But I want to rearrange these clips. So what I'll do is I'll use the little handle on the right hand side, and I'll simply tap and slide my finger up the screen to relocate that clip to the very top. I can repeat that for the other few clips as well, looking out over Cologne, and then when I play my movie, it starts with that lovely title, before going on to the other clips, and then the zoo. Beautiful, and that gives the video a lot more context as well, rather than just being some animals. Now we know those animals are in Cologne. However, on second thought, I perhaps want to put the zoo animals towards the end, and have those nice gardens and fountains before that. That way we build up the cute animals at the end of the video. Now I could do what I did before and manually move each clip up in the order, but that's going to take a while. Instead, let's use groups. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to drag one clip on top of another. That will then create a group, and I'm going to call this Zoo. Then I can go through and drag any other clips into that Zoo section. I can change the order if I want to, or just drop them at the bottom and it will add it at the end of that group. Then I can do the same thing for gardens, just to organise my project a bit more. So I'll drag one clip on top of another, make a new group and call it Gardens. Then we'll add in the remaining footage into that group. To make it easier to navigate my project, I can then use a little chevron arrow to collapse those 2 groups, and then I can simply drag and drop the whole group in one go to change the order of my magic movie. Of course, if I wanted to, I could delete a whole group as well by simply swiping to the left and then tapping delete, but I'm not going to do that on this movie. Now this tip will work in Magic Movies and Storyboard Templates, and a lot of comments on my last 2 videos questioned if you could do this or not. Well, you can. You can make clips longer or shorter, even if the placeholder specified a certain time to begin with. To do it, simply tap on the clip you want to change, press the pencil, and go on to Edit Clip. From here, you can then drag those orange bars to make the clip shorter, or if you know the clip originally was longer, you can extend it as well. So now I've made those flamingos a little bit shorter, I'm going to tap onto the elephant clip as well, and make that a couple of seconds shorter as well, to make my finished film a little bit more punchy. Finally, I've got this nice time lapse looking out over Cologne Cathedral at sunset, and I know that this clip is a little bit longer than what iMovie has trimmed for me. So again, I'll go to Edit Clip, and I'll just pull out that slider to make the clip the full length. That way I can customise exactly what's in my movie to just what I want. By the way, if you're finding this video helpful, please do press subscribe down below, because I'm always making new videos to help you make the most of your iPhone and your iPad, and I'd hate for you to miss any of them. Okay, sales pitch over, here's tip number 4. Okay, jumping into a new project in storyboard mode now, and this one is a book review, I'm going to show you how you can change that template to give yourself more flexibility and more creative options. So what I want to do is add in a whole new section to my book review all about the main characters. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of the placeholders as a starting point. So I'm going to press select and tap the clips that I want to duplicate. I'm thinking I'll take that medium shot, the reference shot, and the close-up shot as a starting point. When I've selected those 3, I'm going to press duplicate on the bottom toolbar, and that will create a copy of that clip underneath the current ones. And now we can start dragging and dropping these clips to rearrange them on my timeline. Just like in tip number 2, we're going to create a new group by dragging one of these clips on top of the other, thereby creating a group. I'm then going to go in and I'll rename this group. So for this one, I'm going to call it Main Characters, and that way I'll know exactly what it is I want when I come to make my video later on. Now you can also rename the individual clips by swiping them sideways and tapping Rename. This is great, especially if you're working with students, as you can then label what you want to have in each of those clips. As it stands at the moment, I've not found a way to edit the description of each clip. If you know a way of doing that, please let me know in the comments down below. Now I've created that new group and I've renamed all 3 clips inside it, I can then minimise all of my groups to see a better look at my structure of the project overall. And now I've customised that storyboard to add a whole new section. It's almost as if I planned it, because tip number 5 follows on exactly from this moment. What we're going to do now is we're going to think, well, actually, I might want to use this template again. But I don't want to have to go through that whole process every time I start a new book review. Now, you can't share a template of a storyboard very easily in iMovie, but there is a clever and fairly simple workaround. First up, we'll press Done to go back to our project overview, and then we're going to tap onto the project that we've been working on. Now, from here, there is a Share button at the bottom of your screen, and this is normally where you export it as a movie. But we want to share the project itself. So tap on the little button at the top, it's quite easy to miss, and then select Project instead. Now you could share this project with other people, for example students or colleagues, very easily by airdropping it or adding it to a platform like Shobi or even sending it by email. But we're going to add it back to our own iPad to create another version of that template. So what we'll do is we'll press Save to Files and then we can choose somewhere in the Files browser to save it. Then, when you've pressed Save, that will create a copy of your project in Files on your iPad or iPhone. Finally, we'll go back to that iMovie home screen, and in the top corner, we're going to press those three dots. From here, you can go to Import Project, and you've guessed it, you can find that project in Files and tap on it to bring it in. I've now got two different book reviews, both the same template, and I can then customize each one. And you can do this as many times as you like. Three dots, Import Project, boom, you've got a third one ready to go. And there you have it, five quick and simple tips to help you make even more out of these new iMovie updates. If you've got any other iMovie tips, please share them in the comments below so other people can see them too. And if you've got any questions, drop them down there as well, and I'll do my best to help you if I can. I hope you found this video helpful. There are literally hundreds more on my YouTube channel down below, so make sure you head over there now. I'll see you next time.